Good morning, everyone. It is Sunday, October 27th, 2024, and it's time for your Sunday reading. I'm Dali. This is the Wolf Girl Oracle, and like always, I'm really glad that you're here. Sundays are the day when we take some time to ask Spirit how we can be healed so that we can help heal the earth. So let's get over to the other camera, and we will get that started. All right, so today we're going to be using the Wisdom of the Hidden Realms Oracle deck by Colette Baron Reed. And we're also going to be using this cute Halloween tarot deck. Seeing that we're so close to Halloween, I thought that would be appropriate and fun. And I'll probably use this week and next week, you know, because it's Halloween season. So why not, right? So I'm going to get the cards shuffled. And as I do, I'm going to ask the angels to protect us. I'm going to ask the spirits of the land and my home to watch over us and surround us. And I'm going to ask the ancestors to give us wisdom. What do we need to know for this week, Spirit? Please and thank you. And I love you. All right, so let's get started here. I'm going to get these shuffled. I'm going to put it in fast forward here so you guys don't have to sit and, you know, deal with me doing this. Okay, here we go. Okay, so as this works here, we progress through the week. So this is the east where the sun rises, the south, the west where the sun sets, and the north. Okay, so we're progressing through the week this way, beginning of the week, midweek, end of the week, and the weekend. Okay, so right away I had two cards flip over while I was shuffling as clarifiers. So let's flip this over and see what this is. If I can pick it up here. We have the Queen of the Light. The Queen of the Light. Illumination, enlightenment, and celebration. The Queen of the Light. Illumination, enlightenment, and celebration. And as the clarifiers, we got the Moon. The Moon as our clarifier number one. And we also got the World. The World. So when you put these three cards together, what you're getting is you're getting kind of the, I'm feeling the push and pull between certainty and uncertainty. Okay. And, you know, because there's so much energy in the collective right now, I can't help but believe that that this is kind of alluding to what's going on with the election right now. You know, I think that some of you are going between feeling extremely confident about the outcome and extremely not confident about the outcome. It's just like it's just swinging back and forth so strongly. You know, that's the difference between the Moon, which is like all these hidden things that are coming out, okay? And the World in the medicine position, which is, you know, far more of a just really feeling unstable, uncertain, shaky ground, that kind of thing, okay? And you, and that's clarifying the Queen of Light, the illumination, enlightenment, and celebration of things. So on one side of the coin, you've got all this confidence. On the other side of the coin, you have like a lot of not confidence. And I feel like Spirit's saying, hey, you need to get that a little bit more towards the middle. These big swings that you're going through is your own mind. Is your own mind playing tricks on you? You're doing too much listening to the garbage, okay? So stop listening to the garbage. Just be confident, especially if you've already voted. If you went and you did early voting or you voted by mail and that part of your life is done and over with now, you've made your contribution, just relax now and let what's going to happen happen, okay? You've done your part. That's all you can do, all right? Listening to all the talking heads, letting all that stuff filter into you is just going to bring out emotions that are not good for you. And it's all a construct anyway. It's a pretense designed to create division, so just relax, okay? If you've done your part, you've done your part. If not, go do your part. Get that burden off of you, okay? All right, and then midweek, we have the keeper of the scales, fairness and balance. The keeper of the scales, fairness and balance. Like justice. And this card flipped over and it is the Three of Ghosts, which in this deck, is like the Three of Cups. So on one hand you have like the Three of Ghosts, which is like friendship, happiness, celebration. It's the meeting of like minds, right? The meeting of like minds all gathering together to be happy about something. And I know that I'm guilty of this. Not that there's anything wrong with celebrating with people who are like-minded. There's definitely not anything wrong with that. But, the keeper of the scales is asking you to remain fair and balanced. And I feel like that's really important right now, because we don't know what the outcome of this election is going to be. We don't know. We can hope, right? We can hope. But this is a very, very tight race, you know, and somebody's not going to be happy. So try to stay fair and balanced and open-armed, because we don't want anyone on the other side of election day to be so raged out that they cause a problem, right? So let's not go into that energy. Let's stay in the fair and balanced and non-judgmental place right now, okay? So let's just stay there and not give in to the temptation to give into that energy that kind of feels good in the moment and fuels us, you know, and makes us excited and kind of in your face. Let's keep that down to a dull roar, okay? For later in the week, towards the end of the week, we have the Fire Prince. Optimism and aggression. Optimism and aggression. The Fire Prince. And we also have the Seven of Imps in the medicine position. The Imps. I don't use this deck very often, so I have to remember what suit the Imps are. One moment. Okay, I just clarified the Seven of Imps in the medicine position is like the Seven of Wands in the medicine position. I had to look it up, I'm sorry. all right, both of these cards, the Fire Prince, the Optimism and Aggression, and the Seven of Imps, are all alluding to being attacked. And it's like our optimism is bringing about that problem. Our optimism is what's bringing about about people wanting to attack us. Okay? The Seven of Wands in the medicine position, this is like a self-defensive, misunderstood, lack of boundaries kind of card, you know? So I think that right now, you know, what I'm feeling from Spirit is, although it is great to feel optimism, don't allow that optimism to either go into aggression or attract aggression, okay? So be mindful just of what you are doing when you're doing it, just to you know, kind of keep the peace, you know? We want to keep the peace right now especially. So just be kind of keep yourself in check, you know? This isn't a time to be like sticking it to the man, you know what I'm saying? So just kind of keep that under control. And for the weekend, we have the Spiral Dancer, you know, which is like route and perception. And we also have the Star. Oh, well, at least we have this beautiful card that we're ending on, because the Star is, you know, it's hope and inspiration and creativity. So I feel like between these two cards, the Spiral Dancer and the Star, I'm feeling this, I am feeling this message coming to us that's, it's hard to put into words. Give me a second here. If we have to remember, we have to remember that our thoughts, our actions, they're all our choice. All right. Our perceptions are our own, just like everyone's perception is their own. Okay. We all have our own path that we walk based on our perceptions. So I feel like it's really important that we keep that in mind, that every individual's ideas, thoughts, and actions are based on the experiences of their life. You know, and even if we want to just take them and sometimes want to shake them up and say, what are you thinking? We have to remember that what they are thinking is coming from a place of perception. Okay? And the best thing that you can do when you have a group of people who are maybe like looking through a window covered in Vaseline, where they're not seeing with crystal clarity how things are. They're actually seeing things in a very muddy sort of way. You know, it's not translucent, it's opaque. So you see lots of shapes and colors and things that you could possibly perceive as being a certain thing, but in actuality is something completely different. And we have a lot of that going on in this election season, okay? There is a lot that is cloudy and murky and fear-provoking, right? So we have to remain patient with those people and understand that all of their aggression is coming from a place of fear. And we have to show them that there is a better way than allowing fear to manipulate you, you know. There's a better way than having rage, you know, direct your action. You know what I'm saying? Oh, Spirit's filling me up with stuff, but this is like hard to get it from what I'm seeing out of my mouth today. But yeah, I hope that made sense. Well, let's go over to the other camera. Well, I just want to thank you guys for stopping by today. I love you guys. I hope that you all have a great week. I will see you all you guys, you know, both on Tuesday and Wednesday between Katie's stream and my stream. Katie's at 11 a.m. Central Standard Time on Tuesday. I'm on Wednesday, Central Standard Time at 10 o'clock. So I hope to see you guys this week. We can kind of celebrate Halloween together. And I love you. All right. Have a great day, everybody. All right. Bye-bye.